Hello students, last class we start to discuss about the structure of the cell and also we start to discuss about the cell organelles. Today, before I start my class, I have a request to all of you, please read the topics what we cover earlier, because when we go through the pattern of question in class 9th and 10th, we can see that most of the questions are one word type questions and also diagram based questions. That's why if you read the topics properly and systematically, that will give you an easy way to score maximum marks. Today we continue the cell organelles. Yesterday we finished up to the Golgi apparatus and today we move to the ribosomes. What are ribosomes? Ribosomes are the smallest cell organelle present in both plant and animal cells. The most important function carried out by ribosome is protein synthesis. The protein are required for the growth and development of the entire cells and body of the organism coming from the function of ribosomes. Now we move to the another cell organelle that is known as lysosome. Lysosome is a cell organelle that presents only in animal cell and it contains 40 different types of enzymes, and this lysosome is a small sac-like structure and its main function is intercellular digestion, especially if any foreign bodies or unwanted structures enter into the cell. Lysosome secretes some of its digestive juices and destroy the unwanted things. But sometimes what is happening, the lysosome blast and the entire cell become destroyed or damaged. That's why lysosome is also known as suicidal bag inside the cell. Next we move to centrosome. Just like lysosome, centrosome also presents only in animal cell. Centrosomes are normally available near to the nucleus and it initiates and regulates the cell division in animal cells. Now we move to plastids. Plastids are color-giving components that present only in plant cells. Normally there are three types of plastids are available in plant cell, namely chromoplast, chloroplast and leucoplast. As I mentioned earlier, chromoplast is mainly concerned to give color to various parts of the plants like flowers, fruits, etc. Chromoplast contain certain color giving pigments like xanthophyll, keratin, etc. Xanthophyll give yellow color to various parts of the plants. Keratin give red and orange color to some of the parts of the plants. Second one is chloroplast. As we already know, it is the pigment, it contains the pigment chlorophyll that give green color to major parts of the plants, especially to the leaves and the tender stems. During the time of photosynthesis, the plants acquire light energy from sun by the help of this chlorophyll that present in chloroplast. The last type of plastid is leucoplast. It is a colorless plastid and mainly help in storage of starch. Potato is one of the very good example for food item that contain leucoplast in large quantity. Now we move to vacuoles. Vacuoles are large space present in the cells of certain plants and very rarely in animals. It is a clear space with water on water or other substances in solution. The main function of the vacuoles are storage of water and also give turgidity to the plant cell, and also it help in elimination of waste materials and also help in storage of food materials. The specialty of vacuole is that it is large and very few in plant cell. In animal cell, very rarely they are available and they are simply scattered in the cytoplasm. Now we move to granules. That is the last cell content. Granules are mainly concerned with the storage of starch and glycogen. Starch is stored in plant cell and glycogen in animal cell by the help of plastids. With the granules. Now we move to the difference between plants and animal cells. As we already know, plant cells are little larger than animal cells, but both are microscopic in nature. What is the main difference between plant and animal cells? When you go through the plant cell, we can see that one outer covering to the cell membrane, that is known as cell wall. This cell wall is one of the notable feature between plants and animal cell. Then we come to the inner side of the cytoplasm. We can see that in plant cell, large vacuoles are there, and they are very few in number also. But in animal cells, these vacuoles are sometimes absent or they are very small in size. You can see here. Then another some major difference between the plant and animal cells are like this. In animal cell, lysosome and centrosome are available, but in plant cell, these two cell organelles are absent. As a conclusion, what we can able to tell, animal cells are smaller than plant cell. Cell wall is present only in plant cell. Plastids are present only in plant cell. Large vacuoles are present only in plant cell. On other hand, in animal cell, lysosome and centrosome are present. These are some of the major difference between plant and animal cell. Now we come to one of the last terms in this chapter, that is protoplasm. What is the meaning of protoplasm? Protoplasm means the entire living substances in an organism, especially inside the cell. Inside the cell, cytoplasm and nucleus together, we can call it as protoplasm. You may get a question like, differentiate between cytoplasm and protoplasm. Cytoplasm is the jelly-like fluid that present inside the cell membrane and outer to the nuclear membrane. But what is protoplasm? It is the entire content inside the cell membrane. That means including cytoplasm and nucleus. One more term we want to study today, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. What is the difference between these two types? Prokaryotic cell means the cells in which the nucleus is not well defined. Mostly it is available in primitive cells like bacteria, blue-green algae, cyanobacteria, etc. In this type of cells, nucleus is not well defined. But in most of the higher organisms like plants and animals, their cells contain well-defined nucleus. That's why they are collectively known as eukaryotic cells. Students, these are the main points we want to study from this chapter 2 cell. Through the School Mitra application, already I sent question answers and all the exercises. I hope all of you are completed all this work. As I tell you in the beginning, please start to read the chapter minimum 2 times. And if you feel any type of doubt from this chapter, please note it and later we will discuss it in class. I wish you a nice day for all of you, and thank you.